Welcome. Let us understand Emile Durkheim's theory of religion and society. A brief introduction. There were many theories given about religion before Durkheim, and he rejected them. Let us discuss some of the theories given before Durkheim. First is E.B. Tylor's theory of animism. Animism is the belief in spirits. He believed that religion is a response to the intellectual needs of man, and he said that it is the earliest form of religion. During ancient times, people believed in death and dreams, and that the individuals used to appear in the dreams or vision of ancient people after the death. That means they remained in touch with the people in the form of soul. The second theory is James Frazer's theory of animatism. He believed that ancient people encountered with many objects in nature which had different characteristics of spirit or power, and it led to the emergence of beliefs that it has some special characteristics and in return relationship with God. The next theory is Max Müller's theory of naturism. He believed that forces of nature have supernatural power. He said that Hindus believe in nature and they developed many rituals around the natural objects, and he said that it is the most ancient form of religion which denoted the worship of nature. According to him, this was a means of satisfying man's emotional needs. When the man had no resort to go to, religion is the last resort where he could look at to satiate his emotional needs and trauma. While Durkheim rejected these theories, he proposed a new theory of his own. Now let us discuss what the theory was. His theory of religion is a functionalist perspective theory which aims to fulfill the basic needs of the society. He said that religion is the need of the society and not of the individual. So, what is the role of religion in the society? It promotes solidarity, harmony, integration, etc. And that is why he said it is a functionalist perspective theory. He said that Arungta tribes of Australia proposed a form of religion which was known as Totemism, where they worshipped Totem, and he said that it is the most simple, basic and first form of religion. This was mentioned in his book, The Elementary Forms of Religious Life. So what is this Totem that Durkheim talks about? Let us understand this. The Australian tribes that he studied, called Arungtas, they were divided into many different clans, and they all had a religious symbol called Totem, which described described and represented their clan. So this could be anything found in nature like a bird, a tree or animal, and it was considered as sacred, which represented the clan, and it was worshipped in return as the symbol of the clan. Emile Durkheim said that when they worship the totem, they worship their own clan, and society is God. So when we worship God, we worship our society. Therefore, God and society are one and the same, according to Durkheim. Now, the religion and the representation of these objects was based on two criteria, that is sacred and profane. What are sacred objects? These objects are related to rituals and belief system of the people. They are symbols and they represent something. They are accepted by the collective consciousness of the society. That means everybody accepts it, and people gather around it every now and then to worship these objects collectively to revitalize the solidarity of the society. These objects, these sacred objects, are considered superior than profane objects, and they direct human action as they have power over the individuals. Second is profane objects. These objects, they do not represent the collective consciousness of the people. Individuals use these objects according to their needs and then they discard them. He said that religion is the requirement of the society and not the individual. Every society needs the symbol and place where they can come together, revitalize their solidarity, and thus religion is a social fact, society is God, and worshipping God is exactly like worshipping the society. This theory was criticized on many grounds. Let us understand them one by one. Various anthropologists criticized this theory and asked justification in defining totemism as a religion. They asked Durkheim how could he define totemism as a religion. They also argued that the theory has little or no relevance in modern society and could be true only in small and uneducated societies. Karl Marx believed that religion is a tool to exploit and divide the society. He said that it is the opium of the people and heart of the heartless. He also argued that religion should not exist in any society as it divides the people and it is a tool to exploit the poor and the needy people. This theory was also criticized because Durkheim was asked to explain how are Aruntas the most primitive tribe. There was no evidence or proof to describe Aruntas as the most primitive tribe. Durkheim ignored the otherworldly aspect of religion and was criticized by Alexander Goldweiser on these grounds. He talked about the functional aspect of religion, that it promotes harmony, solidarity, but he did not discuss the dysfunctional part of religion, which is also the source of exploitation, riots, tensions, customs, etc. Conclusion. In conclusion, we can say that religion strengthens togetherness and unity of a group and it promotes solidarity. Durkheim was correct to express this to represent the functional aspect of religion. The members together express their common faith and beliefs and thus there is an integration of the society and the harmony is promoted. It is the society that defines sacred and profane, and there are social sources of religion. Durkheim saw totemism as a form of collective consciousness which was prevalent in the primitive society, and he also said that religion and society are one and the same, and he also identified society with God. He said that religion improves the functioning and integration of the society. Therefore, Durkheim's attempt and effort to understand religion as a functionalist cannot be ignored and has to be appreciated, but he did not discuss the dysfunctional aspect of religion, which is a flaw in this theory. Now, let us discuss some questions. Question number one. The book Elementary Forms of Religious Life was written by, this book was written by Durkheim, where he discussed society and religion. Second question is, what is the correct match? So we know that animism, the theory of animism was given by E.B. Tylor. The theory of magic was given by James Frazer. And the term totem was given by Emile Durkheim. So this is the correct match. The third question is, the book The Golden Bow was written by, this book was written by James Frazer. Thank you.